Hey, hello guys. Today we're gonna build a website portfolio. And the best part is that you don't have to use any code. But stay till the end of the video because I'm gonna share some secrets that will help you take your portfolio to the next level and help you stand out. So without any more delay, let's just start designing. The first thing that we're gonna do is go to a website called portfolio.adobe.com and you're gonna click in the button get started. We're gonna select the portfolio called Marta and you're gonna use this theme. Since I already have an account, in mine is gonna show something more like this. I just need to add a new site. You can add up to 5. I'm gonna select again the Marta theme and I'm gonna use this theme. I have right now a wireframe of how I want the website to look. Just to give you an idea, we're gonna put a logo, we're gonna add a projects and a contact page, and I'm gonna set it up in a similar way than what I have right here. So let's go back to the design. The first thing I would like to change is this red. I don't like it a lot. So let's go to the navigation, customize, and we're gonna click here. We're gonna add this dark color. Next thing will be the logo. I'm gonna click the logo right now. I'm gonna, instead of having it as a text, I'm gonna have it as an image. And in the normal one, I'm gonna upload. I'm gonna go to the desktop. That's where I have the stuff. This file is gonna be the description of the video so you can follow along. I'm gonna double click it. I'm gonna go to logos and I'm gonna go with the white logo first. Okay, that looks good. And where it says normal, I'm gonna change it to unscroll and I'm gonna upload another image, which is gonna be the black logo. What this does in particular is that when it's normal, it shows like that. When I scroll down, it shows that other way. Okay, now we need to change the color of the work and contact. Let me just manage the pages because I don't have it like work. I'm gonna customize this real quickly. Manage pages, edit collection title. I'm gonna put it projects and contact. Okay, we have projects and contact right now. The next change will be, why does this change to red when we scroll down? And I think I need to go to the navigation, page titles. Okay, shows that regular is like that. Rollover is that color. Active is in white and on scroll should be black. Okay. Okay, now we have it in black when we scroll down and we have it in red, the selected page that we're working on. Okay, the next change will be the masterhead options. We're gonna go into this collection and we're gonna click masterhead and we're gonna click masterhead background and we're gonna upload a video. We're gonna select back in the Adobe website portfolio. We're gonna go to hero video and we're gonna select it and we're gonna open it. And it's gonna take a little bit, but it's gonna process the video in the background. We're gonna go back to that in a second. One thing that this does is that it links my Behance profile with the project, and that's not good for these tutorials. I'm gonna go back to the integrations. And then integrations, I'm gonna disable Behance. That shouldn't be showing me that anymore. And now I'm gonna add the projects that we created before. I added as a GIF image. It's because it makes it more animated. This will make your portfolio stand out a little bit more. Okay, I'm gonna add a page. This page is gonna be Jack's project. I'm gonna go back to the homepage. And in this Jack's project, I'm gonna upload a cover image. I go back to the Adobe Portfolio tutorial. We're gonna go to the page covers. I'm gonna look for the Jack's project GIF. There we go. Open. We have the first project right there. One thing that I would like to change, I don't want that red over there like that. I would like it to be like, let me see if I can edit this page without the page titles. And we're gonna go with the cover images. What I wanna do is try something different. In the overlay, I'm gonna try to put like a dark color. Maybe convert it to grayscale. And this opacity. And let's make the opacity of this 0. Okay, there we go. That's what we have, the overlay. It's gonna get black and white. So that's a good move right there. We're gonna add another page. I'm gonna create a new page and this is gonna be Boost Branding Project. I'm gonna go back to the homepage and I'm gonna keep adding the other projects that I have. So, okay, let's go back to the page and let's start adding all the covers to all the projects. I think this is hard to follow if I do it this way. So I think it would be better if I go back and add the page title so we can, you can actually see the name of each of the projects. This is Crop International. This is Russian Circle. I'm gonna just edit cover image. I'm gonna upload Russian Circle project. We're gonna go with the AmazonLay project, select cover image, and then we're gonna click upload the image and it's gonna be the AmazonLay project, edit page cover image. Let's upload Boost Branding project. And then what project am I missing? Let's just do 6 for the time being. So we have Russian Circle, we have Jax, we have Crop International. Let's try to do the unspoiled one here. Page unspoiled. I'm gonna go back to the page and I'm gonna edit the cover image, upload the cover image. I'm gonna go click here and then we're gonna select the unspoiled GIF. There we go. We're gonna go back to the pages. I'm gonna try to reorganize this. I'm gonna put this one at the end. I'm gonna put Jax at the beginning. Okay, that looks a little bit better. So we have our video going on in the background. We still have to do some changes like in the XD project. We're gonna put graphic designer at the bottom. Instead of scroll down to see more, I'm gonna put graphic designer. Okay, now in this collection, we're gonna go to the masterhead and we're gonna click to the button 1. And where it says this button, we're gonna edit that. We're gonna change that for what we have right here. Let's work together. We're going to paste that right there. Instead of an external URL, we're going to put it to the contact. We're going to change the state of the button. Instead of being an outline, we're going to change it to solid. And the text will be white, but the background should be black. And let's change that opacity to be to 100%. And in the hover version, I want it to be a solid button too, but this time I want it to be white with the text black, but I want it to be 100% opacity. So it should be normal black. It goes white. Let's work together. And it's going to take us to the contact page. We're going really good in this part of the page. And the next step will be to fix the bottom part of this, of the website, to have it exactly how I have it right here. So I'm going to copy this copyright information. I'm going to add it all the way here at the bottom. Okay. Let me see. I'm going to delete this. I'm going to paste it right here. I have copyright, your name, and then graphic design. This is looking good. We're going to go back to the footer, and in the footer options right here, we're going to add social icons. Here we put the links to the social media. I'm going to put twitter.com/Leo Rivero. Here we put behance.net/Leo Rivero. Remove it. There we go. We have the Behance. We go to facebook.com/Leo Rivero. Okay. And then instagram.com/Leo Rivero. Okay, and then boom, we have our four social media icons that are gonna redirect us to the pages, and we have them right there at the top too. Okay, now let's edit the contact form. In the contact form, we're gonna just change this information in edit page info. Instead of contact, it's gonna say, let's work together. Sounds better. In the page description, it could be, let's start a project. Let's try to sound a little bit friendly. Okay, we're gonna put the name. Let's see the fields right now. Let's try to customize the fields. We're gonna have the first one should be name. The second one should be the email address. The third one should be the company. Let's add another one that says company, edit label. I said company or organization to make it sound more professional. Let's add one more. And this one is gonna be edit label. It's gonna be phone number in case they wanna give us their phone number. And then let's add one more that says location. Edit label. I'm gonna put location and put it a little bit higher. And the last one is gonna be the message. I'm gonna click done. And our final step will be to publish the site. Let's see the site. And this will bring us to the final result, a really nice website that looks really clean and it has a bunch of animations going on. If you feel like you learned something new, just give a like to the video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.